I gotta tell what I feel. I gotta talk about my life as I see it.
What is their message? What message are they sending?
Who sending?
The American people who voted for Trump, the losers.
The message that, okay, a couple things based on what you said. One of the positives that came out of this is that although the Civil War era was maybe more based around racial lines and greater physical boundaries, the difference here is that the divide is urban versus rural, and the suburbs seem to be split. The more outer suburbs are going with the Republican, and the more urban inner city suburbs are going with the Democrat. But this is much more, this whole century will be ideological battles much more than ethnic battles, which in a way is good, because politicians will pander to what they think their base is. And if they don't think their base is going to be so tightly around racial lines in the future, it'll actually just be a battle of ideas. And that's actually a healthy development, in my opinion. What do the Trump people want? They wanted Trump. They wanted a continuation of what the positives he brought, the positives that the media did not talk about, which was no new foreign wars, a decent foreign policy for the first time in a long time, standing up to interest, domestic and foreign. They probably did not want his attitude to be as crazy as it was, because as much as the news portrays that all these people love everything he says, in reality, all Trump supporters I talk to would wish he could tone it down. So I see a lot of similarities in that people are afraid of the people on the other side, or they're afraid of what they might do. For now, for the time being, Biden's a real friendly guy. He seems to be toning down toning down everything with his speeches, at least. But policy matters too. Everything might be somewhat cool for this, with Biden saying all this nice stuff, but if he tries to go with more lockdowns, if they try to ban guns, this is going to be on like Donkey Kong.
Well, I don't think that that's going to be the issue. I think
what's facing... That's in his policy platform. Both of those are.
Well, here's the thing. The reason I believe that Donald Trump ultimately failed is because of his domestic issues, his domestic problems. If you don't take care of home... which he ran on, if you remember, he ran on that platform to win. And folks came out to support him because he put, quote unquote, America first. Now, ironically, that's exactly what failed him in this election, because he was so concerned with making sure that the economy, making sure that China, making sure that when it came down to handling domestic problems, Corona, COVID, he failed dramatically. Well, so that for me, and as well as the obviously the racial issues that we've been talking about, not addressing those properly. So when we're talking about what he really did in regards to what he said, he failed. Making America great again means making the American people believe that he is a good leader domestically, and he failed dramatically.
Consider this, George. It looks like the exit polls have shown an slight increased boost of Trump amongst all minorities that you could think of, whether it be Latino, Black, Native American, Muslim, women. The demographic that he lost in the election is older, white, male. However, is it that Trump lost those voters, or is that we as a country have lost those voters due to the coronavirus?
What say ye, Tim?
Well, I mean, I think one thing with Trump is that, and this was a surprising thing just on election night that we really discovered, is that it wasn't a runaway for either candidate. You know, I think the Democrats expected Biden to walk away with it. Same with Trump, the Trump supporters. It was going to be, and I kind of went that way too. I thought it was going to be one way or another. I thought it was going to be a landslide, and it wasn't. It was a pretty even divide of the votes. It just that Biden came out just a little bit ahead, and I mean, I think that kind of just goes to show that, you know, how we misinterpret you know, the voting population of Republicans and conservatives. And I think one of the things that they were talking about during the exit polls was that, okay, well, why did you vote for Trump? What was the reasons for it? And a lot of it did come down to the economy. They thought, okay, yes, you know, maybe he could have done a better job with Corona, but they didn't want to be locked down again. It's like if you have a small business, it's like they thought, okay, well, Trump is going to try to open up things, whereas Biden is going to just shut things down again. If you're a small business, you're thinking, oh man, there's no way I can survive on this again. I mean, I don't want to see people dying, but I also want my business to open. I also want to make money. I also want to have a living. I want to have my job. I want to have whatever. So I think that was the number one thing, is that they trusted Trump more with the economy than they did with Biden. And hold on, one more thing. Sorry. And that was the thing I was sitting there listening through all the different liberal media, was that it was a gut check moment for the Democrats, because they have to look at it and say, okay, there were 70 million people that voted for Trump, and we're still counting, but 70 plus million people that voted for Trump. Why was that? What did the Democrats do wrong? How did they not get their message out? If Republicans thought that Republican voters thought that Trump was going to do a better job with the economy, then in the future elections, that's where the narrative needs to go away, or needs to change. Is that Democrats need to do a better job of explaining to the American public how their policies are better, how they're better for working class, how voting for them is in their best interest versus voting for a Republican. And that's where they have not done a great job at.
And 70 million people might rather take their chances getting and potentially dying of coronavirus than dealing with social justice warrior bullshit.